I'm attempting to be the first person ever to beat the zombie burrito challenge at Keikiaki in LA. So I'm hitting Hollywood Boulevard for some much needed advice.
It's a 2-pound burrito, but it has ghost chili extract, so it's really, really spicy. How should I take this thing down?
Can I drink milk? Potatoes?
Eat potatoes.
Yeah.
So, Mr. Muscles, I gotta take on this burrito. It's called a zombie burrito.
Bingo! You know!
What's that?
Going down!
Going down, what's that?
You know!
You know, bingo!
You know!
Hey.
Okay, you gotta put your arms up.
Like this? Hey, buddy. I gotta take on this challenge, and it's called a zombie challenge. You gonna whisper in my ear? Oh, she believes in me.
With that sage advice, I head just south of LA to Lakewood for a burrito so spicy, it scared off every other challenger.
I'm in Los Angeles at Keikiaki, where I'll be the first to take on the zombie burrito challenge. Finish a 2-pound burrito drenched in ghost chili infused hot sauce, and I'll make history. Dead end.
Open in 2009, Keikiaki dishes out a flame-grilled array of fusion tacos, rice balls, and loaded fries.
I have ninja fries.
So French fries covered in ninja sauce, like LA fusion at its best.
Yeah. It is.
But what put Keikiaki on the Epic Eats map is their hot sauce.
So what kind of sauce do you have?
It's their ninja sauce.
The ninja sauce, yeah. Which is the mildest of all the sauces.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I believe so.
Oh, well, it's hot enough for me.
From the satisfyingly spicy ninja sauce, to the habanero and cayenne death sauce, to the ghost chili-infused zombie sauce, which singes the scales at 3 million Scoville units, or about 600 times hotter than a jalapeno.
Then you're familiar with the zombie taco and...
Oh, yeah. I only got about 3/4 of the way through.
What started as a taco challenge with a 97% failure rate has evolved into a big bad burrito challenge, 5 times bigger and 10 times hotter. Behold, the zombie burrito. And so far, no one has been brave enough to try it.
Would you ever take on the 2.5-pound zombie burrito?
I probably wouldn't even want to try it.
Any advice?
I need you to run.
Run?
Yeah.
Against my better judgment, I run to the kitchen to be the first ever zombie challenger.
This is the first time we're doing the zombie burrito, man, right?
Yeah.
Have you ever eaten the zombie burrito?
When I was making it, I tried it, and I regret it, dude.
Feeling really confident.
Oh, my God.
And dive right into the most deadly element of this challenge, the zombie sauce.
We got some hot stuff. I see all these crazy colors. They're beautiful, right? But they're deadly.
David begins by boiling habanero and cayenne peppers into a flaming hot stock.
Traditionally, you use a chicken or beef stock to make sauce, but you're making
a pepper stock. Yep.
I don't know if I like that or not.
We mix in sriracha, tapatio, a local red pepper sauce, and Louisiana-style hot sauce.
We put a little tang to the bang that's already in here.
Then this sauce goes nuclear.
All right. Ghost chili extract. So over 3 million Scoville units.
It's pure heat, in my opinion.
That's what makes you undead.
9, 10.
That's drops. Don't do this at home. That's it, look at that color. And I can smell it, it smells incredible. It's just, it's a little deadly.
To a double thick cheesy tortilla base, we add David's signature bacon fried rice.
And this is where it starts getting painful. Our first layer, we start off with death sauce.
Yeah, so first you kill me with the death sauce, and then I turn into a zombie.
Yeah.
Sweet.
We grill up some teriyaki beef and chicken.
I think it's funny that you're cooking your own demise.
Yeah, David, you're a wicked, wicked man.
Then comes the killer, a deluge of zombie sauce.
Oh, God.
For a Keikiaki twist, we add french fries, taquitos, and mozzarella sticks. And then, for the heck of it, some flaming hot Cheetos.
So what were you doing when you came up with this thing? You were busy thinking about stuff.
Yeah, I was way too busy.
A final layer of onion, cilantro, and ninja sauce.
All right, let's do this.
Rip it up!
And my zombie burrito is complete.
Look at that thing. It's like a baby manatee. David, it's time to raise the dead.
Rule number one, you have to finish the whole burrito. And there is no time limit for you to do that. You must stay seated, and you cannot eat or drink anything else but the zombie burrito. You guys ready for this?
Immediately, this zombie burrito is deadly.
Yeah. I got to eat. Wow.
I'm only 3 bites in, and I'm basically breathing fire.
Kill that zombie! Kill that zombie!
Man, Casey looks like he's struggling right now. He's already sweating and he's already turning red.
What do you guys say? Can Casey do it?
This LA crowd is spurring me onward. But with every bite I take, the zombie bites back.
I mean, the spice is coming from every angle.
And one of us isn't gonna make it. I'm suffering every symptom of zombie spice overload. Sulfurous sweats, ghoulish growls, and of course...
I got the hiccup.
Save us from the zombie, Casey! Let's go!
Some foe, but every bite is like dying 1,000 spice-induced deaths.
So hot.
No time limit to the challenge. It's a classic battle of good versus evil. Living versus undead. Man versus zombie.
We believe in you, Casey. Woo! You're almost there. The pain will be over soon.
Dude, I gotta give him props. I only could eat like a quarter of that. And he's just killing it. I'm witnessing history right now.
Victory is so close, I can almost taste it.
One more bite! One more bite! One more bite! One more bite!
But the zombie heat is so overwhelming.
That's a beast.
I'm nearly dead in my tracks.